All right. Good morning here in the loud neighborhood. But I did. Oh, I got a picture of the black silky raven today. Not a great one because of the distance shot, but it's there, and I put it on as a lynx, and it's at the so you can spot him. But it's not like I said. It's not very good and clear. Oh, darn it. But I wanted really to talk today. I did see him. I'm pretty sure I see him circling very high above, very high altitude circular above this region. So that's kind of exciting. Okay, but what I really, really, and he's solitary. He's a solitary fellow. He's not group oriented like the others. The other ravens tend to hang out together. This guy is pretty solitary. He looks Italian, as I put in the little words there. His coat is very, very slick, very shiny, very oily, and he looks Italian. His eyes are deeper set. They are kind of like a low set brow, so he looks a little bit more like a, you know, that you know, kind of guy. He's not wide-eyed and bushy-tailed like many of the other ravens. Okay. So anyway, so what I really want to talk about today is the effeminate male. The effeminate male. I'm looking at an article today this morning, the Daily Mail, Co. UK, and it's discussing the increase of effeminate males. Now we are looking at the reason being we're talking total sex changeovers are going on here a lot more and more commonly because of pollution with very, very common things that are used all the time, namely oestrogen drugs. Now those are normally things that women take to stop with to go with their birth control cycle. So when we have those getting flown into our water supply and our water system, and the men have been living in the same place their whole entire life, it has altered their personalities. It has made them effeminate. It has made them passive, where they don't really even know aggression any longer, where they are scared. It has turned them into, I don't want to say a gay male necessarily, because I'm not against gay males ever, but it has turned them much closer to be gay males, and therefore easier to be gay males. Okay, so we've changed. I'm not saying we, but yeah, the waste, the waters, the pollutants that are still in our water supply. Has it really been proven that all of this has gotten out? That we have removed all of this birth control out of the water supply? Has it been proven that we've removed the food liners out of the water supply? Where was the other? We have the sufficants also. When we have the snapping turtle in Florida that apparently has decided he's not going to snap anymore, he's just gay. When we have frogs that are now hermaphrodites all over the planet near these regions that are city waste pollutants. Okay, so when you're living in an area that is a city waste pollutant, oh yeah, now I imagine this video would upset a passive male also because my hair is out of place. So this is what we're dealing with. They have gone that far. Do you understand? In their head. They have gone that far that they cannot handle any waves. When you've lived in an area and you've become passivated by its water supply, its polluted water supply, you can't handle waves. You know, plus other things that go on in your life. Maybe you take prescription drugs also. You can't handle the waves any longer. So I don't know what to do, because I am a forthright person. I'm a bold person. I'm a daring person. But when it comes to, and I'm a traveling person, and I've drunk water from all over the world, and a lot of the times it's been water from places that have not had chemical attachments. I've lived many times out in the countrysides, not had chemical flow attachments on my own water system from deep dug wells. So I'm like, well, what is going on here in the city? I return to the city and I'm finding like zombie drones. What's going on? Why are they acting like zombie drones? Why are they acting so passive? Now, all I can think of is we're not filtering the water enough. Firstly, I'm like, they're taking drugs. They're on something. You know, that's not my first impression. You know, they are on something. They're taking, and it's not even marijuana. I don't know what it is. You know, that's been my first reaction. It's like a total personality change. They've lost their forthrightness. They've lost their attitude. They've lost their bold. They've just become like too nice. So when people have become too nice, well, I guess it's a population control, or we can look at it that way. But it's, I mean, oh my gosh, what a strange attitude am I to show up and arrive when they're all swirling around and they're too nice. Anyway, so, you know, I guess they were yelling about this, you know. The cutesy little environmentalists were yelling about this 20 years ago, 30 years ago. What about the water supply? What about the water supply? What are you people doing about our water supply? And now look, now we just have effeminate males everywhere. We have species that have just changed. They've just changed. They've met the male of the species animal has become a female. So, and yeah, we are animals also. So gosh darn it, because you're not the same human beings that when I left. You're just not the same human beings. Now, this is particularly happening with men. I cannot state that this is happening with women on the same manner. This is really happening with the males of the human race. This effeminacy, overboard, the effeminacy overboard syndrome. So yeah, I don't know. Anyways, just remember that the water does make the males of this society more and more passive rather than aggressive. I look up here and it says passive aggressive often, and I'm like, no, it's not doing that. It's making them constantly passive. Constantly passive is not a good state to be in, because that makes them scared. It means they're too scared. Their scare level happens too quickly. It's accelerated. Oh my gosh, I'm scared, like right away, like, oh my gosh. No, that is a reaction. That is a chemical reaction. You've been introduced, you've had too many chemicals flowing through you. And that's straight even from our polluted world here. Okay. I know that's not really helping solve it today, but this is just a reminder of the frustration that these overpassivateds cause. to the ones that, oh my gosh, I'm back to the Bay Area, and what happened to them?